Hey everybody, this is Kevin at the Woodcraft Shop, and today we're going to put together one of these WoodRiver knife kits. All of our kits come with a list of supplies you need, as well as a set of directions. I picked out a set of our Bolivian Rosewood knife scales for the handle. I think those will look really nice. And I'm going to change it up. Instead of the regular pins that come in the knife kit, I'm going to use one of our Mosaic knife pins. First, we need to determine which side of the knife scales we want facing outwards. We're going to mark those with an O towards the front of the knife. So it'll look like this. Next, we're going to use some double-sided tape to join the two halves of the scales so we can cut them out and they're exactly the same shape. You want to make sure that the scales are oriented the right way and that all the sides are flush. Just press them together, and now we're going to trace the profile. Now we're going to hop over to the scroll saw and cut this out. You can use a bandsaw, coping saw, whatever you want. Just make sure that you cut to the outside of the lines. That was just to remove the bulk of the material. We'll go back and shape it up and give it the details later. Now that we're going to be messing with the pieces while they're attached to the knife blank, I'm going to go ahead and cover the blade with a couple layers of blue painter's tape. Remember, safety first.
I've attached half the scale to the knife, and we're going to use this as a template to drill the holes.
Now we're going to clean everything with some acetone to make sure there's no grease or anything on it. Make sure the epoxy doesn't have any problems sticking. The good thing about the pins that come with the knife is they're already cut to size. But they're bland, we don't want to use those. We're going to use the Mosaic pins. So we're going to do a little dry fit, stick the pin in there, and then use a marker to mark on the pins where we need to cut it. I'm just using a hacksaw to cut the pins. I cut the three pieces that we needed for this knife out of the Mosaic pin, and there's still a pretty big chunk left. You could easily get two more pieces for another knife.
All right, so now we're going to mix up some 5-minute epoxy.
You want to make sure you get the epoxy all the way to the edges because that's what's going to hold everything together. I also highly recommend using some gloves for this part, which I obviously didn't do. That'll just help you from sticking to anything. Now we're going to brush some epoxy on the first pin and stick it in. And you want to make sure you twist the pin while it's going in so it spreads the epoxy around.
There we go.
You could do this on a piece of cardboard to make sure your knife isn't getting glued to the bench. And you want to make sure the pins are centered. You don't want them to be sticking out on one side and not on the other.
All right, so we've got the pins in. We've got it all epoxied up. I'm going to throw some clamps on this real quick. You can never have too many clamps. Remember that, kids. So the epoxy's all cured and it's out of the clamps. And now we're onto the fun part. We're going to shape this handle to however we want to shape it. Probably just going to go with something simple, round over all the edges, make sure it's nice and easy to hold, because right now it's not that comfortable. I'm going to take it over to the belt sander and we'll get started. All right, so I've got the rough shape that I like from the belt sander and the spindle sander. Now I'm gonna put it in this vise and just sand up through the grits, make sure all the edges are nice and smooth and it feels good to hold in the hand. Really good way to get the nice round over on the knife is to fold your sandpaper around it and kind of go back and forth like this. However, you wanna make sure after you do that, you go back and sand with the grain to get out all the scratches. All right, got it shaped up, got it sanded up to 220. I like the look and feel of it. It feels really nice in the hand. Now we just gotta put some finish on it. To finish the knife, you can pretty much use whatever you want. If you're gonna use your knife a whole lot and it's gonna see a lot of abuse, you're gonna wanna go with a sturdier finish like a polyurethane or a Waterlox. I'm probably not going to use this knife a whole lot, so I'm just going to go with this because I've got it open for another project. All All right, now I'll just let that sit. I'll put a few more coats on that according to the instructions, and we'll be back. So the kitchen knife over here, I did it in Purple Heart. It's just got the regular pins in it. And then this is the Rosewood handled Skinner knife that I just did with the Mosaic pins in it. There's a close up of the regular pins. Right, you know, that's fine, it looks nice, but I think that pin just looks real nice. Just add something.
I hope you enjoyed this video. To get your own knife blank and scales, head on over to your local Woodcraft store or online to woodcraft.com.